This is a mecha. This is mecha. This is mecha. This is how to draw a mecha. Hello, everyone. Have you ever wanted to draw a super cool mecha, but don't know how? Well, today with me, your host,
I guess this whole format kind of demands, like, an actual host or avatar or some such. Boy, it sure is too bad most YouTube avatars are kind of, you know, a blatant expression of the insecurities of the video maker through the super ego of the form of their chosen avatar. There are a few exceptions, of course. Just give me one moment, please. There we go, perfect. So, as I was saying, it's me, your host, Argonbolt. And of course, our wonderful co-host, Wackyprof. Who is Wackyprof, you ask? Silly viewers, Wackyprof was once two foolish YouTubers who created tremendously bad or biased videos, with little backing understanding or well-fleshed-out arguments. So, I alchemically condensed them into one more space-efficient form and bound them to be the co-host of this wonderful program. Without further ado, let's go over what we'll be having fun with on today's program. Today, I will teach you how to design your very own mecha. But to do that, we're going to go over some stuff to get you ready. We're going to learn why it's not always best to just copy others' homework when it comes to mechanical design. Next, we're going to talk about how ranting for close to 3 hours does not a good argument make, and just how much you can blame a design for a show's problems. And lastly, I will tell you the secret formula to quickly and amazingly draw a real mecha. But first, let's have a quick commercial break, and I'll see you right after.
They nest unseen inside your wall. The damage could cost thousands, but
TV
can be stopped by the Exterminator, the Orkin Man. The Exterminator wipes out
TV troops.
The awesome power of his advanced pest control technology. He destroys
TV troops
nests and makes sure they never return. Orkin. One call destroys them all.
Now maybe you have tried to draw a picture of a mecha, and it comes out like this. What's gone wrong here? The colors are very off, which is something you really need a good sense of color theory to balance. The shading is also quite rough, it doesn't really exist. Likewise, they're humanoid, but the proportions are wacky. So you might want to skip straight to drawing the machines. When you start drawing mecha, it does help to know the human body. And practicing human proportions really does help. And in addition, knowing how to work with perspective is very useful for properly shaping and positioning elements inside a work. It also helps not to talk on things you don't really understand too well beyond a surface level. Isn't that right, Wackyprof? No, the real problem here is quite simple. It doesn't really know how to make the art in question because it's only ever seen the finished product. This is a really big error I see a lot of young artists making, in which other people help to encourage because they also lack any artistic training or understanding. Let me put it to you like this. Did you have a kid in your class who could perfectly draw Pikachu really well? Or say, any kind of anime-like design? Like Inuyasha, who's pretty cool. I had a teacher once who absolutely barred any such work, and you might ask why? Anime and manga are an art form, right? Why refuse any work like that as an art teacher? The reason is simple. It gets back to the way artists should work. When you just copy a design, you're not making the same gradual series of creative choices the original artist did. You're just replicating the finished pattern. Think of it like this. You've eaten food for many years. You want to start cooking. Yum! But the only idea of food you have is finished meals. Pizza, burgers, soup, and so on. So when you try to give others advice, you can only make vague statements like soup is usually wet, or burgers have many layers. If you were given a whole farm to pick ingredients from, you would have no idea where to start, and you would just starve to death instead. You don't know how to turn animals and vegetables into ingredients into meals. If you ever wondered why all those shitty book fair fucking books on learning to draw anime generally sucked ass, here's the same reason. Art is about creatively deciding on how to present something. Manga and anime are art with set rules and approaches. Mangaka and animators, and mechanical designers and so on, fine-tune to express those rules in order to create a final design. Out of all of which you get your final Gundam, or Sailor Moon, or whatever. By only skipping and copying that final design, your art will always be ass, because you have essentially failed to do the same job. You are just replicating, or telling others, to replicate the patterns without truthfully considering them, or understanding where they come from. You are like the cook on the farm who can't comprehend a form of food that doesn't come in a can or cardboard box. You're disconnected from the actual creative process to make these things. For an example of the right approach, look at an artist like Brian Lee O'Malley. His popular works like Scott Pilgrim show off a style that was clearly inspired perhaps by manga and anime. However, while he might have started there, he went back and reverse developed the right creative approach to illustration and art, and he made it his own. For a very different approach, but also great, you can see mechanical designers like Sid Mead. Sid Mead was able to very astutely break down the conventions of what worked in an originally Japanese work like Gundam, and then reinterpret that through his well-developed personal style. Both of these examples use Japanese design as a basis, but then add their own creative process. And this is why you can easily find on DeviantArt and Gundam fan wikis a practical ocean of shitty, ugly mechanical designs. It's the same thing as the Scholastic How to Draw Anime books. It's once again much easier for people to just copy parts of a design. It's not as hard as developing and practicing a real personal style. That takes much longer and much more effort. Instead, they start and then usually stop at this awkward stage. But that's also why their art looks so garish in comparison, and why it breaks what are once working designs. Because they don't really understand what they're doing wrong, or how they're breaking it, or they just lack the ability to just make that work in the first place. And here, a certain someone is a perfect example of this. His style is very amateurish and basic, because he fundamentally is lacking that actual artistic skill and talent. I mean, already for a history major, he has the most basic bitch cultural understanding, and it looks like his art is no better. Because here, let me tell you a little secret. If you've watched every season of Gundam twice, it doesn't matter. You're not an expert in anything. If you spend 10,000 hours watching anime, you don't become a better artist. It might inspire you, but all you've done is spend 10,000 hours watching anime. If you spend 10,000 hours practicing your art, you will become a better artist. It's really that simple. But that's also hard. It takes time, as I said before, and it takes effort. So instead, people get to this easy fake plateau of copying finished designs, of smashing them together, because it gives them that little tingle of satisfaction, as if they had made a good design themselves. But that's all that it is, a broken Frankenstein. It's a fake plateau where most people stop. If you want to be good, you need to push yourself past it and work hard. And that leads perhaps to the even more brutal fucking truth. If you practice art, if you study design and talented designers, and actually know the principles of design, you can watch only one mecha show and not be a mecha fan and know what works, how it works, and how to do it yourself. If you've only watched a million hours of shows and understand nothing of design, your opinion is, ironically, at best, and most reasonably, a personal preference. However, if you are certain people, at its worst, and you preach it as, quote, a editorial, it has the value of dirt. You're still just a consumer, you're not really an artist. So let's go over the final point of this big lesson. Basically, don't just copy shit, and don't be lazy. Duh. If you want to design mechanical design well, or just make good art in general, well, it's nice to copy stuff early on, as it gives you the satisfaction of making something that looks like what you think you want, you basically have to eventually start honing your own sense of style. Figure out what inspires you. Figure out what you like. It's a big point. Why just copy when you can really make a design feel personal to you? Then combine that with good fundamentals, like the ability to draw perspective and proportion. These make your art feel satisfyingly well expressed, and not infantile or clumsy. You won't always succeed. You will probably make lots of mistakes, and it will take a while, but there are no shortcuts. Practice, practice, practice. That is the path to skill. And after a few years, you'll be able to make work that is both personal to your own life and is satisfying to create. You will become a much better artist for it in the long run. And after all, between the Big Bang and the end of the universe, you actually will only exist for a tiny smidge of that time span. Do you really want to spend that finite time span just copying others? Doesn't that render your existence redundant? Your whole minute life replaceable, as if you never really even existed in the first place. Not truly alive, but a simulacra of a shadow of living. After the break, we'll deal with the stupidity of a loud moron. Narf! Ah, hello. Welcome back. So you've spent a long time on your design. You like it, and you put a lot of effort into it. You did pretty much everything you could to match exactly what you needed to express the ideas of the design. You were right on the money. But what if the show is bad? What if it's really bad? Is that your fault? Ah, this classic video. I recall when my friends and I would just try to see how long we could last watching this miserable, uncoordinated, loud rant. It was like watching a man lock himself out of his own house, and instead of doing anything sensible, he decides he's going to try to eat his way through the bricks. 2 hours have passed, and instead, he just has a mouth that's a bloody mess. Not to mention, he managed to actually make the thing he hates seem pretty good, because he did such a poor job calling it bad. Truly a master stroke of stupidity. If you expected a point-by-point breakdown, I'm sorry. I'd have sooner benefit to, say, picking the corn kernels out of people's turds at a sewage plant than going through this with a fine comb. But to the main point, as it relates to design, see bad! If you want more details on why, don't worry. I have something coming in the works for Gundam. All of it, in fact. But for now, let's get to the root. What happens when your show is bad? How much is it a design's fault? After all, mechanical designers and their designs are just one part of such a larger team. Starting off, animation problems are not your fault, right? That's the problem of the animators in dealing with animating your design. Directors for pacing out how much time your big robot will need to be animated. And way at the top, series runners for what they asked you to do relative to what they could actually animate and work with on their budget. So yeah, Seed and Seed Destiny has animation issues. But none of that is on just purely the mechanical design. That's all stuff you can lay at the feet of those in charge. Cause I'ma be honest here, Japanese animators are paid like shit, and they're miserable. They don't need me to make fun of them. Likewise, you can't really put plot problems on just the design either. Even though story might make us love or hate a design, the design is usually worked out before, or at the latest, mid-production. You really can't pull just out of all the things, just the design, and act like it's a magic secret source of evil for a show. That's just fucking stupid. And possibly the most stupid is quoting finite, specific, stupid tech bullshit no one cares about. These details are so minuscule as to obsess over it It's almost absurd this is even the crux of your argument. Sometimes I wonder, did I really need to go so in-depth on some of those aspects of Ace Combat 7 in my review? Was it just too much? But then I see something like this.
Two Solidus Fulgore energy shields on it!
And in comparison, no, I really did not. For example, I spent about only 13 minutes in total talking about the space elevator as a detail. In comparison, you could watch that, take a nap, eat dinner, go for a quick drive to the 7-Eleven, and come back. And he would still be talking about this one goddamn robot design. And this is what I meant before. If you, any of you, make a video this fucking long and bad, and loud, Jesus Christ, please stop screaming, even people who might initially agree with you will maybe support the opposite of what you are saying because you are so shit at saying it. So I will say this to both of you. I can make your points better than you can. I can hate more efficiently than you can hate, and elegantly and more directly love the things you love better than you. You can't even be nerds right. You made a grave mistake consuming the same media as me. So what can we judge a design on, really? In a nutshell, what it is trying to do. That is, what is the conceptual basis of the design? Yeah, I know, boo-hoo. It's technical art stuff, and not some childish incoherent rant that sounds like it was spoken by the living equivalent of the caps lock key. It's not some animation or plot judgment. It's just judging the design fairly on what it tried to do. So what did Seed's design try to do with the Destiny Gundam? Now, Seed has some big mechanical design shittiness, don't get me wrong. But once again, to be fair, to just this design in particular, as if we handed it in ourselves, we have to look at just this single example. While worse designs and better designs reflect the entire show, this is once again just one design on its own. And, what can I say? In concept, it does exactly what the Freedom did. It's a loud, flamboyant design that's a bit garish, but ultimately is what Gundam Seed's concept is. A new version of the Universal Century that is louder, brighter, more melodramatic, and made to try to appeal to a younger audience, and just generally more in your face. Any criticisms you can apply to the Destiny, you could apply to basically any other Seed or Destiny design. Nothing about this one is astoundingly distinct, and in some ways it's not even the worst offender. It's like a lot of stuff from the early 2000s that was obnoxiously working its way through what was, in essence, the corporate absorption of the design trends of the 90s. It's in your face, and kind of annoying at it. The big thing, really, is everything he complains about with a Destiny Gundam is also present all over elsewhere in Seed and its other designs. But if you think about it, Seed was, what, the ninth fucking Gundam show? Some design aspects are of course going to be carried over from previous stuff by default. And for that same complaint of originality, look at the other Seed Gundams. The Freedom rips off all the same minute design details from previous stuff, so crucifying just the Destiny over it seems a bit weird. The problem seems to be multi-present along pretty much all of Seed's design. And that's the thing, really. It doesn't make any sense to single out just the Destiny Gundam as some special degree, and there really perhaps is the true answer. The reason Destiny's design is singled out by him, it's because he could not separate his emotional hatred for the show it belonged to from this one design itself. And that is what happened instead. He and all the people who agree with him and lack the brain cells to actually understand why they hated that show, instead focused on the Destiny Gundam's design as basically a symbol to pour their hate into instead. It's basically just one giant coping mechanism. So yeah, when you boil it down, it's just the pure concept. Not any of the larger flaws with the series on any such level. Purely a mechanical design. So the default judgment for me is, it's perfectly workable. It's not revolutionary, it's not astounding, or even the first in the trend, and I'm not a personal fan of it, but it's not the worst, and it's definitely also not like what some people said it was. They acted like it was the coming of the Antichrist or something. Fuck, at least it don't got no awful Robin's Egg blue shit going on. And don't got that black and gold bullshit either. So this is the key to our second point. As hard as it is, when making a new mechanical design, you cannot rely on the same emotional attachment to a completed design in a finished series. It's hard for some people because they know Mecha from its finished form, as part of a larger story. Animated, controlled by characters, some of which are shit. But the reality is they are only ever designed as part of that. You can't exactly retroactively pin all the other parts and problems on just that bit. This is the logic of an infantile moron. Like getting, angry at the color of Sonic's shoes, maybe? But of course, that's only the half of it. Because not only was the original criticism a giant mess, they also went out of their way to present an alternative. Oh boy. An actual work. A counter-argument. And judging by how many people got involved, they all channeled their collective dislike of Sea Destiny into some amazing super special redesign. Let's see what they produced. Oh my goodness, it's... Wow. It's another seed design. After ranting and raving and running this massive collective effort, the best they could come up with was some lateral and forgettable alternative. That's... wow. I sure hope they did not waste too much time on this. At least the art is, well, you know, that's kind of been nicely rendered well enough. So, you know, some points for that. If this was just some random DeviantArt redesign, I'd probably go, meh? That's okay. Or maybe it's from Astray? But the amount of buildup for what is, at best possible, a lateral design step is pretty fucking comical. Like, if you're gonna say Destiny is, quote, the worst Gundam you have ever seen in your whole life, only to then make a suit design indistinguishable and forgettable outside of some cosmetic changes from that, you have to really see the irony, right? Like, listen, you can post in your friggin' Chris Chan channel about how you're not as bad as him, do you spend a collective hour and 20 minutes complaining about how bad a design was for you? That was basically your Sonic. Then, you built up to a big reveal of what ended up being your own original yellow Sonic. As far as anyone unfortunate enough to find your videos is concerned, when it comes to this stuff, yes, you are the Chris Chan. You and your opinions are kind of a fucking joke.
Mech warrior. 60 tons of power under my seat. Mech warrior's not for people who can't stand the heat. Virtual reality, aim and shoot with my 3D cockpit simulation view. Jump jets, laser beams, cannons, full bore, heat-seeking missiles and shields on board. Combat, got attack, go for the thrills, get the cash, paying back. Yo, you got the skills. Plan ahead, use your head, think and be wise. Your thumb's not alone, you gotta strategize. Visuals, colors, popping, sound in the brain. You live mech warrior, it's a mean fighting game.
Mech warrior.
Ah, and so, we're back. And now, for our final segment, the wonderful thing you've been waiting for. The incredible secret technique I unlocked after studying the masters of mechanical design for decades. Here it is, the big reveal. The amazing secret that will turn you into a master of mechanical design for any mecha or any vehicle. It's 10,000 hours of drawing practice, and studying real machines and other artists. What the fuck did you expect? There is no shortcut. If you're just going to try to copy the pattern of real artists, you will make something that seems great, but it's only a copy. You don't have any real design ability, skill, or original creativity. The best you can do is half-baked knockoffs.
The point today was to show you two idiots, both without that critical design skill, both who represent creative dead ends you should avoid if you want to do mechanical design. The first, who only made basic bitch observations because despite his ego and despite years of videos, he doesn't really seem to get mechanical design beyond that surface level. He doesn't really seem to get mecha very well either. And the other, who was so arrogant, loud, and stupid that he went on a gigantic dipshit rant, all because he was too brainless to separate his dislike for something, for a piece of media, from one single aspect, a single fucking mechanical design, who then laughably tried to cope with this by then making a design which was ironically guilty of all the exact same design trends.
You want some good advice? Don't do what they did. Maybe watch my mechanical design videos. Practice your art every day. Make a personal style. And get started. because one day, you'll be dead. In the meantime, maybe I will eventually do a full video on how to draw a mecha. That sounds kind of fun. Otherwise, I really need to testify in court, so goodbye forever. Thank you.